Savatekalia. Savatekalia, 1761-1842, was a merchant and among the first Serbs to have defended a doctoral thesis in jurisprudence, Doctor of Law, and in particular in legal theory and philosophy in 1786 at the University of Pest, president of the Matica Srpska, philanthropist, noble, and merchant. Tekelia founded in Budapest the Tekelianum, Collegium Tekelianum, in 1838 for Serb students studying in the city. Tekelia was a big patron of the Matica Srpska and he opened a Matica library in the Tekelianum. He is related to Peter Tekeli and Jovan Tekelia. Life. Born in Arad in the Habsburg monarchy, today's Romania, Tekelia studied at a Serb elementary school, went to a Buda gymnasium, and studied law and commerce in Pest. He finished his studies in 1785, taking high jurisprudence honors. From this time he practically devoted his life to social work among the poor Serbs of Budapest, and he became well known as a social reformer and philanthropist, at home and abroad. As a merchant, Tekelia made a princely fortune very early on in his career. Convened by Metropolitan Moise Putnik shortly before his death, Tekelia was among the many participants of the May 1790 Serbian Church Congress, Sabor, in Temeswar where political and military representatives of Serb people in the Habsburg monarchy gathered. The clergy no longer dominated their own assembly, thanks to Putnik's efforts in making the Sabor a people's assembly. The senior officers led by Colonel Arsenij Sekujic demanded the establishment of a separate Serb region within the Habsburg monarchy. Sava Tekelia was in opposition to the military demands, preferring negotiations with the emperor. In the Serb-populated parts of the Ottoman Empire, Tekelia was trusted and honored as an ardent supporter of Karadjordj. He contributed munificently towards the prosecution of that leader's war policy. He also did his best to advocate and promote education among the Serbs in the Habsburg Kingdom of Hungary and elsewhere as a means of reconciling Serbs and Hungarians and raising the character of his people. Tekelia was also the leader of the Illyrian political thought of his time. He submitted a memorandum to the German-Austrian Emperor Francis II in 1805 encouraging the Austrian army to help the Serbs re-establish their national medieval empire. Nevertheless, his greatest service to Serbs as philanthropist was the institution, named after him Tekelianum for Serb youth seeking higher education. Sava Popovic Tekelia comes from a famous Serb family of noblemen. His great-grandfather Jovan led frontier military units in 1697, which significantly contributed the victory of Prince Eugene of Savoy in the battle against Ottomans near Sinta. In 1706, he was awarded a hereditary title of a nobleman because of his military merits. In the family, there were other famous people. One of the best known is Sava's uncle Peter Tekeli, a general in the army of the Russian Empress Catherine the Great. Sava Tekelia was first educated in a Serbian and then in a Latin school in Arad. He attended the senior grammar school in Buda. In the meantime, he had attended the classes of rhetoric. He studied law in the University of Vienna and he learned French, Italian and Spanish. He also attended natural sciences classes, where he studied anatomy, chemistry, botany and mathematics. At the same time, he acquired some education in music. He finished his studies of law at the University of Budapest in 1785 and there he defended his doctoral thesis entitled De causa et fine civitatis, on the cause and purpose of the existence of the state, the following year. Thus becoming the first Serb PhD of legal sciences in the country at the time. The thesis was written in the spirit of the French legal encyclopedists and Enlightenment, under the influence of the philosophy of Jean-Jacques Rousseau. Sarvatekalia supported in various ways the Serb rebels in Ottoman Empire who fought for the liberation of Serbia from Ottoman rule. In 1805, he translated the book Romans in Spain by Watson, and in the preface he presented his plan for the renewal of the Serbian state. Following the ideas of French educators, he actively worked on the education of the people. He thought that strong intellectual elite should be formed in order to reconnect the Serb people with European trends. His educational mission and charitable activities coincided to a great extent with the aims of Matica Srpska, which had been founded in Budapest in 1826 by a young doctorate student Jovan Hadzic, a senator of the magistrate of Novi Sad. An author of the Serbian civil law from 1844, and a group of rich businessmen, George Stankovic, Joseph Milovic, Jovan Dimitrovic, Gavrilo Bogotovic, Andrija Rozmajerovic and Petar Rajic. In 1838, Sarvatekalia was elected the president of Matica Srpska, which was one of the most significant events in the history of the Serb people. He interceded for Matica Srpska to become a scientific society. Because of that, Matica Srpska today has 7 scientific departments. He played a crucial role in the formation of a rich library fund that was the basis of the Library of Matica Srpska. He also formed a solid ground for the shaping of the Serbian pantheon, whose funds were later used for the foundation of the Gallery of Matica Srpska and the Museum of Vojvodina. In all of these activities, his endowment Tekelianum, founded in 1838, played a significant role. The Tekelianum Endowment. I want to found it in Budapest, a scientific environment, for which purpose I bought a house near the church and the university. I want 12 students to come to Budapest and learn, have a place to live and 100 forints for support, and later arrangements shall be made. I will put this under consideration in Matica Srpska, which will also get the 3 rooms for the supervisor, 1 for the library, 1 for the pantheon or for meetings, and 1 for students. Although he officially gave the supervision of the endowment to Matica, the founder still oversaw everything himself and managed the affairs. He personally cared for the endowment building and its residents until disease and old age forced him to return to his hometown of Arad. He cared for the endowment with a lot of concern and dedication, which is confirmed by one of his contemporaries. He founded and managed this foundation with such will that he was the one to acquire everything necessary for the residents. He himself stuffed straw mattresses with straw and sewed them. Tekelianum was later taken care of by professional supervisors. The first one was the secretary of Matica Srpska Tudor Pavlovic. That duty was later given to Jovan Jovanovic Zmaj, one of the most famous Serb poets. The residents of the endowment, Tekelianists, were Bogdan Gavrilovic, the rector of the University of Belgrade and the president of the Serbian Royal Academy of Sciences, Radivoj Kašanin, a famous Serbian mathematician, Tihomir Ostojić, editor of the annual review and secretary of Matica, Marko Maletin, editor of the annual review and secretary of Matica, Jovan Pavlovic, a prominent journalist, Veljko Petrovic, writer and president of Matica, Lazo Tomanovic, journalist and president of the government of Montenegro, as well as several hundred other Serb intellectuals. The property of Tekelianum was nationalized in 1952. At that time, the endowment temporarily stopped working. In 1966, in the process of denationalization, the Hungarian authorities returned half of the Tekelianum Palace to the Buda Eparchy of the Serbian Orthodox Church. Tekelianum Palace. From its foundation in 1838, the seat of the Tekelianum, the endowment of Sarvatekalia, was located in an elite part of downtown Budapest, which was highly populated by Serbs since the end of the 17th century. The fiduciaries of Sava Tekelia's endowment made the decision to raise the old two-story structure in 1906. On the same spot in 1907, construction was begun of a new building, according to the design of the architect Sandor Fellner. Construction was entrusted to the engineer Ahil Duka. Vladimir Vukovic did the carpentry, Nikola Vrančić the ironwork, and the artist Nikola Stanković did the decorative painting. Numerous decorative elements of the building were overlaid with ceramics produced in the Zolnay factory in Pec. The front facade of this monumental five-story building is symmetrically laid out in a carefully planned rhythm of architectural elements. The vertical separation is highlighted by two dominant semicircular porticos above which there are low-relief contoured bay windows and hanging eaves. In the center of the facade on the third floor, there is a long balcony and there are two other shorter ones on the sides of the wings on the fourth floor. All the balconies are enclosed and set on massive high-relief corbels. The magnificence of the facade is enhanced by the placement of a wide variety of types of windows, architraves, semicircular single-pane, dual-pane and triple-pane windows, along with a wealth of two-dimensional and unusual ornamentation along the window frames, on the capitals of the pilasters, and on the fascia and cordons of the roof. Elements of Serbian medieval architecture and of the secessionist style, quite modern at the time of the building's design, are notable features of the building of the Tekelianum. Click on the subscribe button on the YouTube channel, in order to be updated with the latest events on the channel. Help our work by sharing content.